Yes, yes.
How does he promote? Checks her heart. Oh, he's ready, she's ready. It must die. And I mean, you have to literally open your mouth and give him your life when you're back. Hey, listen, if you don't give him your life voluntarily, he will make sure your back is against the wall. And you'll realize one day you're in a situation and you just can't. You realize, you're stuck. I can't do it. I can't do it. And you go into brokenness. And that's when the tears come. You cry. All night long, you'll cry. You've got to be broken so that God can get your flesh out of you so that you can know that you can't do this thing yourself. You got to let him do it. So if you're not obedient, he will make sure that he gets you. You see, do we want to go through all that? I mean, I'm trying to save you all the agony and the grief. One of the reasons why we have good mentors and leaders in our lives is to save us from all the trouble. To save us from the headaches. Will you just listen? Listen to your pastors. Listen to your mentors. The ones that God has placed in your life. He's a connector of persons. He connects you because you're a family. You know, that family is more important than your blood family. You know that? It's a part of your spiritual lineage. And if you mess it up, when you go before God, he will judge you on it. How did you handle it when I appointed brother so-and-so in your life? When I appointed you the pastor that you were supposed to stand with, how did you handle it? I'm just keeping it real today. Because God might want to save thousands of souls through you by connecting you with that pastor. But instead you wanted to go your way. Oh, I don't like that. It's not what you like. It's what God says. He knows what's best for you. And you have many. I've run across them. They want to do their own thing. And they fall into rebellion. And then all hell starts to break through in their life. Nobody did it but them. Out of what? Ignorance. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. God has a plan for you. And whoever he sends in your life, whoever he's ordained in your life, is for impartation. You must receive a mantle, an anointing. Hallelujah. And so, yielding to the Lord is very important. Killing of the flesh, I say, die. I still ask the Lord to kill me. My flesh must die in order for me to do the great work that he's called me to do. I must die daily. Daily death. On the cross. Daily death. On the cross. Don't be proud. Be humble. He loves when you're humble. He can use you when you're humble. Humility. And so we must ask him to help us to die. We can't do it ourselves because so much is coming at us. We try to get close to God and the devil will use even your very family members to pull you out. You have to fight for it. You have to fight to say, the phone is ringing, I gotta go here, I gotta go there, I gotta do this, I gotta do that. You can't even spend an hour with God. You must spend time with him so that he can become your friend and you can get divine instructions. Because aren't you tired of being messed up so many years? I mean, aren't you tired of the devil punching on you? I got so tired of it. And that's when he said, okay, now I can use you. Now you're giving me room to step in. And I just said, you know what? I don't even care. I don't even care what anybody thinks of me. I don't even care. I'm just going to do what God says. Because, you know what? It's not even worth it for me to be going through all this foolishness. So much foolishness. It's easier. Because guess what? The enemy will try to fight you and scare some of you, right? But you must stay focused on God. You always have victory. That's Jericho. And I'm skipping. I'm not going into the meat of everything. I'm just giving you enough. You go to Jericho, he promotes you when you're ready, when your heart is right, and he takes you to Jericho. Amen? Spiritual location. For some of you, you've got to move from where you're living. You've got to be separated. You've got to come out from among them. Because you cannot move forward in God if you're still in that same mess. If you're still attached to so-and-so, hooked up with, linked up with. Some of them you just have to let go and love them from a distance. Because there is in this season. In this season, and God will separate you. So when they don't call you anymore, don't worry about it. Holy Spirit is separating them. It's time to come out from among them and be ye separated, says God. And they will call you weird. They'll call you crazy. I've even had pastors, recently a pastor called me and said, you are weird. I said, thank you. Why? Because my husband and I are spending a lot of time praying for the nations right now. We pray for people in Pakistan, India, Norway, Sweden, Jamaica, Trinidad, so many places. I can't remember them all. But God says, pray for the nations. That's what he's saying for us to do right now. Pray for the nations. We have needs too, but God says, pray for the nations. But as we're praying, God is blessing us. You see, some people are afraid to do that because they're afraid of coming under attack by territorial spirits. And believe me, they will come around. They come around us, and as soon as they come, Holy Ghost reveal them. Out. You've got to go out. Out the door in Jesus' name. The blood is in here. That's why you have victory in Jericho. It's war, but you have victory. Because in Gilgal, he teaches you the word. You've got to learn the word. When you get to Bethel, your flesh dies. Then when you get to Jericho, God can start to use you. He will start to use you in Jericho. And he will send the people to you when you're ready. You don't have to go fight. You don't have to say, I'm a minister. No. Holy Spirit will send them to you when he knows you're ready. Promotion. Hallelujah. So, yes. So this is how it works. He sends them to you. And you just do what he says to do. You want the blessing? You know, I remember in Bethel when Jacob wrestled with God. God was wrestling the flesh out of him. He wanted the blessing. He wanted it. But he did not want to let go of what was so good over here. But God wrestled the flesh out of him. And guess what happened? He got his name changed to Israel. Some of you, God has a spiritual name for you, but you don't know it yet because you're not ready. God has a spiritual name for each and every one of you in this house today. Don't you want to know it? It will help you decipher all this cobweb. All the cobweb and the stumbling blocks and the hindrance. It will just help you so much quicker. That's what he did over there in Bethel with Jacob. And now in Jericho, we cannot be afraid. He will deliver you. If you're going through stuff in your life, Jericho is the place where you will get deliverance. I mean, supernatural deliverance. If perversion is bothering you, if lust is bothering you, God, Holy Ghost will deliver you. You can't do it yourself. It's done by His Spirit. Hallelujah. If witchcraft is bothering you, hey, if you know somebody who is into witchcraft and you're close to them, it's going to affect you. Association brings impartation. Who are you associating with? You got to come out from among them so that it will not affect you. That's why God separates you when he's bringing you through. Do you need to be delivered from bondage? Whoredom, that's smoking. Spirit of whoredom, that's smoking. Drinking alcohol or drinking liquor. Pornography, even on the TV. On the computer. What is it that you like more than God? That's your God. That's a spirit of whoredom. God will deliver you in Jericho. Why? Because it's time for deliverance. Because in order for him to use you to set the captives free, you have got to be free yourself. So guess what? It's cleaning time. Don't you want that? The enemy comes in to mess up God's people. Mess us up even from the womb. You hear what I'm saying? mom or somebody in your line. Had an abortion. It follows you. Spirit of death. And you wonder why you try to do things and it comes to a death. I'm talking about deliverance now. Anything you try to do comes to a death. You do it for a little while and it dies. Spirit of death has been connected to you through lineage, bloodline. What kind of agreement did you make with somebody a while ago? What kind of covenant? What kind of contract did you sign? Come on now, we gotta be careful. We gotta walk in the spirit so that we will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. When somebody comes to you with foolishness, trash, if it's not lining up with what God has already revealed to you, and he speaks to you through visions, dreams, in your belly, true prophets, he sends confirmation in the mouth of two or three, speaks to you through the word, he speaks to you, open, close visions, so many ways. His voice, his audible voice, he's speaking to you. So if he's talking to you, what business do you have connecting, hooking up with, making a contract with, a deal with? Do you know what they're into? You got to go to God. He is the master and maker of your life. You know what the Lord told my husband and I before we got married? He said, don't make any decisions without me. Don't make any decisions without first coming to me. So guess what? When people come to us, the first person I go to is, okay, Lord, who sent them? Did you send them? I don't care how good they look, how good they smell, how sweet it tastes, how good they sound. I don't want to fall into no more traps. Yeah. You know how many traps I fell into before I gave God my life? Yeah. Traps. And there are, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. God says to tell you there are many traps out here. Yeah. Many. Yeah. Hallelujah. Well, hey, I'm trying to save you today from the traps, says the Lord thy God. Traps. They come. Sounding so good, so sweet. That devil is a liar. Devil is a liar. And for some of you young men, the devil loves to use the young people and their body as a playing ground, a romping ground. God said to tell you this day, don't fall into any traps. No more traps. So when they talk trash on the phone, cut them off. Cut them off. God has work for you to do. He says, young man, I call on you while you're young. Don't you want God to choose your wife for you? Don't you want God to choose your husband for you? That'd be so much better. So much better. You know, they won't take off on you and do foolishness. As long as you pray. And you will get a fight. But you know you have the blood. In Jericho, there is warfare, but victory. The devil will fight you you will get all kinds of attack in Jericho. But God says, don't be afraid, because I got you. The blood, all you have to do is call on Jesus. In Jericho, call on Jesus, and he will show up. Open your mouth. Don't lay there and be quiet. If it's 1, 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, get up and open your mouth and sound the alarm in Zion. Yes. Tired? There's no time to be tired. These are the end times. Hallelujah. And so, that place of Jordan. And we're going to